Hi, this is Alexandria, Minnesota chiropractor, Dr. David Butler. In this video, I'd like to talk about symptoms. So, what is a symptom? Well, most people think symptoms are, well, it's just a pain. In other words, most people tend to think the symptom is the problem. So when they go to the doctor, their main concern is to do something to get rid of that pain or get rid of the symptom, right? But symptoms are really like fire alarms going off in your body, or like a red warning light going off in the car dashboard. And you know, when a fire alarm goes off in your house, it's telling you there's something much more dangerous going on. Maybe the battery needs to be changed. Well, symptoms are your body's smoke detectors, and it's the body screaming out that it needs help. So symptoms are not meant to be covered up or to be ignored. You'd never take the batteries out of your fire alarm or your smoke detectors, right? Now, what would happen to your house? Well, if a fire were real, your house may burn down. And you would certainly never put tape over your check engine light, although I've seen that, because what would eventually happen? Well, the car would break down and maybe leave you stranded someplace, right? But yet, when it comes to the human body, we all do just that. See, we've been trained by TV, magazine ads, newspapers, our friends, family, the radios, and yes, unfortunately, even our doctors, that when you have a symptom, you cover it. You mask it up with a drug, a pill, a potion, a lotion, or if the symptom is bad enough, maybe they'll offer you a surgery. But is your problem and what caused it still there? Of course it is. So if your problem, the root cause of your problem, represents the fire, and you're masking it, or you're taking the batteries out of the fire alarm, what's going to eventually happen to the building, which is your house or your body? Well, it's going to burn down, and it's going to die early. So a symptom is really a warning, because by the time you have a symptom, a health problem has already existed, and the nerves are already extremely inflamed, and you're already in a crisis. And the symptom doesn't necessarily let you know the location or the cause of the problem. For example, well, let's say you have a neck pain or it's constantly sore in your neck. Well, the nerves are inflamed, and you could be having heart problems, thyroid problems, immune system problems, but you don't feel the heart, you don't feel the thyroid, or the immune system. And whether you feel the pain or not, those nerves in your neck are how your body communicates, both from the organs but back to it, every cell in your body. From the brain to those organs or systems, they're already inflamed. The body's in crisis enough to shut down the function causing diseases in the body. Because when there's a heart problem, a hormonal problem, a thyroid problem, or any health problem. And I'm just using the neck here for example, but it could be a lung or some other system or some other issue. Whenever your body perceives a problem, it reacts the same way and it tries to correct it. And when it can't, it then tries to let you know with a symptom. And when you ignore that, that's when disease develops. Remember, health is 100% function. And so what disease is less than optimal function. We tend to think disease, especially like a name disease, is something you feel. Well, often it's not. A disease is, well, it's something in the body not functioning correctly. You often can't feel the disease process until there's been enough cell and tissue damage that all of a sudden, there go the flares. There's the pain. There's the symptoms. There's the sickness and the disease. And the worst symptom of all is early death, because you never felt it. The biggest killers in our country today are not the ones that you feel. It's the ones that you don't feel, because most people don't feel diabetes catching on. Most people don't feel Alzheimer's coming on. And you don't feel a lot of the other diseases like cancers and heart disease. Yet they're the biggest killers of all. So we simply can't base our health on how we feel. And having a symptom-based healthcare practitioner is certainly never going to be the best for your health. You want to be proactive, not reactive, for you and your family. The difference here is reactive care is what we're taught and is what's practiced in this country, mostly crisis care. For most of us, if we have a problem, we react to it versus being proactive, which means taking care of your health now so that you can avoid and prevent all those things. So you're not reacting to a tremendous disease crisis down the road. Remember a symptom. When you feel a symptom, it's already a warning signal of something much more dangerous going on. So please tell your friends and people you work with, and especially if you see people rubbing their necks or their backs or something frequently, or they're complaining they have to take a pill for this condition or that condition. Be a friend. Say, hey, I used to think that way, but you know what? Listen, I know you think that's just a headache. I know you think it's just a neck pain from working, but it could be something else. And the nerves in your body could already be inflamed, and they could be signaling a disease crisis in your body right now. And you have to find the cause of it, especially if it's coming back over and over again. So don't take the batteries out of your fire alarm. Don't put duct tape or black tape over the check engine light. Be proactive. Take care of your health for the rest of your life. Remember, if you don't take care of your body, where are you going to live? And remember, if you want to learn more about real health and wellness without drugs and without surgeries, contact the team of Century Chiropractic. This is Dr. David Butler wishing you good health, and we'll see you next time. Bye.